नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
श्लोक नंबर 23।
तन्मातरौ निज सुतो घृणाया स्नुवन्त्यो पंकांगरा रुचिरा उपग्रीय दोर्भ्याम दत्वा स्तनं प्रबितोस्म मुखं निरीक्ष्य मुग्धस्मितालापदशनं ययतो प्रमोदम्।
Like to read word to word.
Tan matarau, their mothers Rohini and Yashoda, Nijastanau, Nijasutau, their own respective sons, Grihinaya, with great affection, Snuvantyo, allowed to suck the flowing milk from their breast very happily. Panka Angaraga Ruchirao, whose beautiful transcendental bodies were covered with muddy cow dung and urine. Upagriya, taking care of. Dorbhyam, by their arms. Dattva, delivering them. Stanam, the breast. Prapibato, when the babies were sucking. Sma, indeed. Mukham, the mouth. Nirikshya, and seeing. Mugdasmita alpadashanam, smiling with little teeth coming out of their mouths. They were more and more attracted. Yayato, and enjoyed. Pramodam, transcendental bliss. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Shri Prabhupada. Dressed with muddy earth, mixed with cow dung and cow urine, the babies looked very beautiful. And when they went to their mothers, both Yashoda and Rohini picked them up with great affection, embraced them and allowed them to suck the milk flowing from their breast. While sucking the breast, the babies smiled and their small teeth were visible. Their mothers, upon seeing those beautiful teeth, enjoyed great transcendental bliss. Purported by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Shri Prabhupada. As the mothers cared for their respective babies, by the arrangement of Yoga Maya, the babies were thinking, here is my mother. And the mothers thought, here is my son. Because of affection, milk naturally flowed from the mother's breast and the babies drank it. When the mothers saw small teeth coming in, they would count them and be happy. They would count the teeth and then they would feel happy. And when the babies saw their mothers allowing them to drink their breast milk, the babies also felt transcendental pleasure. As this transcendental affection continued between Rohini and Balaram and Yashoda and Krishna, they all enjoyed transcendental bliss. Jai Prabhupada. ॐ अज्ञान्तिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकं वंदेहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतः पदकमलं श्रीगुरोन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपां साग्रजातां सहगना रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपदान् सहगनललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितंश्च नमः ओं विष्णुपदाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 रामो 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्ण। सीक द मर्सी ऑफ द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज टू स्पीक समथिंग इन परंपरा। टू स्पीक बिफोर डिवोटीज इज लाइक वर्शिपिंग मदर गंगा। You take the water of the Ganga and offer it back to Ganga. So the blessings of devotees, we try to speak something, and that the words are actually coming because of mercy. So I pray for the mercy of Gurudev, Prabhupada and all the assembled devotees to speak something about this Vrindavan Leela in Vrindavan Dham. There is one very beautiful shloka in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. One great devotee came to meet Lord Chaitanya in Prayag. When Lord Chaitanya was staying in Prayag, Prayag is the confluence of Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati, Triveni Sangam. So Lord Chaitanya, when he was on his way to Vrindavan, he stopped in Prayag. So he met one great devotee whose name was Raghupati Upadhyay, you know. So Lord Chaitanya, he told him, you speak something about Krishna. And Raghupati Upadhyay spoke one very nice verse. I do not know so much Sanskrit, but the verse is that some worship Smriti, some worship Shruti, some people worship Mahabharat, but I worship Nanda Maharaj. Why? In whose courtyard? The Supreme Brahman is crawling like a baby. Aham hi Nandam Vande. Nanda Maharaj is so glorious that in his courtyard, the Param Brahma, the source of all the spiritual and material worlds, Sarva Karanam, Karanam, Govindam, Krishna, is crawling like a baby. So this Balya Leela of the Lord is very sweet. At the same time, it is very bewildering. How the Absolute Truth, who is making the whole world dance, Ekala Ishvara Krishna Arasava Britya Jare Jaiche Nachaise Taiche Kare Nitya. Krishna is one person who is making everybody dance. Like Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Tumi Sarveshvara Ishvara Brajendra Kumar Tomara Icha Brahma Korena Srijan. Oh my Lord, you are the Sarveshvara Ishvara, the Ishvara of all Ishvara, Sarva Karana Karana. Tomara Icha Brahma Korena Srijan. Lord Brahma is creating by your desire. Lord Vishnu is maintaining by your power. Lord Shiva destroys by your power. Durga Devi has created this huge material world. It's a very fantastic jail. How Durga Devi has created this material world. It's a jail, but there are no walls. There is no boundary. So everyone is thinking, I am very happy. I am a free bird. But actually everybody is in a jail. What would you prefer in a jail? A first class room on the first floor or on the ground floor? Yes? Vrindavan Vihari Prabhu, what is your choice? Generally ground floor is better, ne? What do you prefer in the jail, first floor or ground floor?
Jail is jail.
Jail is jail. Prabhu, you are saying, I want to get out of the jail. What is the point in staying in the jail? But all this material world, everyone is working hard just to get better accommodation in the jail. You know, when I was born, I was in a very small room in the jail. I worked hard as an IT industrial and worked, earned lakhs of rupees, and now I have got a better cell in the jail. You know? So the real purpose is to get out of the jail. One devotee was asking me, how can we improve our chanting this morning? So I quoted from Srila Prabhupada. Prabhupada says, the first thing is that you must understand that you are in a foreign world. You are in the wrong place. And you must have this desire to get out of this material world. Then your chanting will improve. So long as we are thinking, I am okay, I am happy, so you will not feel like getting out of this world. You have to understand, kahin galat phas gaye, I am in the wrong place, right? I must get out. So, discussion of the pastimes of Krishna and hearing His holy name, these are the means by which the soul is freed from all material desires and becomes eligible to enter into the spiritual realm. Like Prahlad Maharaj, next week we will be celebrating Narsingh Chaturdashi, 25th I think, next Tuesday, 7-8 days. So there's a very beautiful verse. And Prahlad Maharaj, his father is inquiring that, Prahlad, what is the best thing you have studied in school? And Prahlad Maharaj replies, Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Pada Sevanam Archanam Vandanam Dasyam Sakhyam Adma. Shravanam Kirtanam. Prabhupada emphasizes these two things, hearing about Krishna and chanting the holy name. And among all nine also, the most important is the chanting of the holy name. Sanatana Goswami asked Lord Chaitanya in Jagannath Puri that which is the best, the most important means. Actually, Sarvam Bhattacharya asked in Puri and Sanatana Goswami also. And Lord Chaitanya replied, Tarmade Sarvashreshta Nama Sankirtan Niraparade Namalaya Pai Premadhan. That among all the processes of devotional service, the most important is to chant the holy name Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. But Niraparade, without offense. That is why every day we take shelter of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu. Because by remembering Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda, all offenses are forgiven. Prabhupada writes in one purport that in the chanting of the holy name of Krishna, there is fear of offenses. Bahu janme kare yadi shravan kirtan tabu na pai Krishna pade premadhan. Even if one engages many, many births for hearing and chanting, he may not attain perfection. But Chaitanya Nityananda Nahi Esa Vichar Nam Laite Prem De Bahya Shrudhar. But in chanting the name of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu, all offenses are cut to pieces. And pure devotional service becomes awakened. So we should constantly take shelter of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is the Prem Data, the giver of love. He is giving the holy name, the means. So coming back to this verse from Raghupati Upadhyay, he says, some people worship Shruti, Smriti, but I worship Nanda Baba, in whose courtyard Krishna is crawling like a baby. It is very bewildering. On one hand, Krishna is creating the material world as the expansion of the expansion of expansion, Mahavishnu. And when he is breathing out, so many universes are coming out. We are fortunate that still the Lord is breathing out. When he breathes in, the entire creation is finished. But that same person, the source of Balaram, Vasudev, Sankarshan, Krishna, Aniruddha, all the Leela avatars, Yuga avatars, Manvantara avatar, now that same baby Krishna is learning how to walk. He's become captivated by the love of his devotees. Some gopis, they say, Krishna, if you dance nicely, we'll give you one sweet. Just like we get one sweet after giving Bhagavatam class. You know? So Krishna is being tempted, he will get one sweet. And Krishna is dancing. Just to please, just to get a sweet. He is the source of all sweets. All the milk of all the universes, all the sweets are coming from Krishna. But Krishna is attracted by the sweet, not by the sweet physically, but the sweetness of the love of his devotee. That is one of the greatest qualities of Krishna, is that he becomes subordinate to the love of his devotee. Krishna says to Arjuna, the Adi Puran, that anybody who chants my name with feeling, I tell you frankly, Krishna says, the word is used frankly, he purchases me with devotion. One who has devotion to Krishna, he purchases the Lord. The Lord becomes his property. The Lord says, you can sell me anywhere you like. He told Vasudev Datta, Vasudev, I am your property. Lord Chaitanya said to Vasudev, I am the property of Vasudev Datta. He can sell me anywhere he likes. Because Vasudev Datta has that love. It's interesting because Vasudev Datta is Prahlad Maharaj in Krishna, in Narasingha Leela. In Gaur Leela he becomes Vasudev Datta. And same mood is there. Like Prahlad Maharaj in his prayers, he says, as for myself, I am not worried. Tadvira gayana mahamagna chitta. Wherever I am, I will sing your glories. I am happy. Narayana para sarve na kutashchana bibhyati swarga pavarga narakeshu api tulyartha darshana. Therefore, the devotee who is attached to Lord Narayana or attached to Krishna, it does not matter whether he is in heaven or in hell or in spiritual world. Like once Prabhupada was walking in New York and devotees passed through some area which was dirty and, you know, like not so good area, and devotees were begging forgiveness. Prabhupada, we're sorry we brought you here. Prabhupada smiled, he said, if you have eyes to see, you will see Vaikuntha here also. Pure devotee, he is seeing Krishna everywhere. So he is always in Vaikuntha. He is always in Goloka. You know, it is a matter of consciousness. A conditioned living being like me, who is filled with unlimited material desire. I mean, physically I am in Vrindavan. But where is my heart? My heart is still attached to the material sense gratification. But pure devotee, Vishaya Chhadiya Kabe Shuddha Habe Mana Tabe Hama Heri Bo Shri Vrindavan. When my heart becomes freed from the desire to enjoy sense gratification, then I can see Vrindavan. Vrindavan is actually the place for Paramahamsas. Because we are, at least I am a very low beginning devotee, but we can aspire to be qualified to receive the dust of Vrindavan Dham. So, Prahlad Maharaj is saying in his prayers to Narasingha Dev, as far as I am concerned, it does not make difference for me. I will just follow in the footsteps of great souls and sing your glories. Singing the glories of the Lord is the way to overcome all the pollution of this material world, to free the mind from all pollution of the lust, greed, the three modes of material nature. Just like nowadays, this corona people have sanitizers and vaccines, you know. The holy name is the supreme vaccine. Now this vaccine which we are, you know, it's good, but there are limitations, you know. But the vaccine of the holy name, there are no limitations, you know. So we should take, you can take 1,600-1,700 doses per day also. There is no side effect. The holy name is the supreme sanitizer. Sanitizer means something which purifies. The holy name of God is Param Pavitra. It is pure and it makes others pure. Nama Chintamani Krishna Chaitanya Rasavir Nitya Mukta Purna Shuddha Purna Shuddha Abhinna Nama Namitvam. The holy name is Purna Shuddha, completely pure. Anybody who chants the holy name, he also becomes pure from within and without. Om Pavitro Pavitro Va Sarvan Vastan Gatu. So to take shelter of the holy name is the way to get purified. So Prahlad Maharaj is saying, I am always, wherever I am remembering you, I am not worried. But I am worried about the fools and rascals who are trying to enjoy this material world. This is the consciousness of a Mahabhagavata. A Mahabhagavata is one who is always para-dukha-dukhi. Para-dukha-dukhi. In the material world, most people are para-sukha-dukhi or para-dukha-sukhi, you know. But a Vaishnava is para-dukha-dukhi. Like Srila Prabhupada, when he was in Mayapur, And once there was a big festival, everybody had nice feast, and as everybody was going to take some rest in the afternoon, Prabhupada saw from his window that there were some very poor local people who were struggling to get some prasad. Actually they were taking from the thrown away leaflets, from the plates. They were so hungry. They were fighting like with each other. And Prabhupada had tears. He called all the GBC leaders, called all the devotees, said, nobody should go hungry here. There should be distribution of prasad. So Prabhupada had concern for everybody. Everybody. So this is a Vaishnava. He is always thinking of the welfare of all living beings, not only spiritually, but also materially, in every way. One devotee was telling me the story that Prabhupada was in one temple and one Mataji came to, you know, meet, and she was pregnant at that time. So Prabhupada told her that now in this stage you should take proper diet since you are carrying a child, and then he told you should take hot milk. Immediately called the president of the temple. He thought some important seva. So he called the temple president, told that make sure that this Mataji should get hot milk. And she said, okay. And Prabhupada said, no, bring it right now, right now. And that devotee brought the milk, and Prabhupada told her to take the milk. You know. So Prabhupada had concern for the child in the womb of the mother also. You know. So this consciousness of having concern and feeling the pain of other living beings is a sign of advanced devotee. If one is rendering devotional service externally, but one does not feel pain on seeing the sufferings of others, then his practice is not yet perfect. The perfection of spiritual life is when one becomes Surida Sarvadehinam. Like Krishna is the friend of all living beings, pure devotee also become the friend of all living beings. So, coming back to the story of Vasudev Datta, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he asked Vasudev, Vasudev, I want to fulfill your desire. What do you desire? Anything. And Vasudev Thakur, he offered this beautiful prayer. He said, my heart breaks to see the sufferings of all living beings. If at all you want to give me something, my Lord, please, please deliver all living beings. Take all living beings back home, back to Godhead. And if you think they are not qualified, they are very sinful, then transfer their sin to me. Let me suffer for their sinful activities. I am willing to go to hell forever if it helps others go back to Godhead. And Lord Chaitanya was in tears. He said, Vasudev, it's not surprising that you are speaking like this, O Vasudev, because you are incarnation of Prahlad Maharaj. Do not worry. All living beings will go back home, back to Godhead, just by your desire. When a pure devotee desires something, Krishna fulfills that desire. Prabhupada desired to have this beautiful temple become manifest. So, but do not worry. All will go back to Godhead and you will not have to suffer. You will not have to suffer. So, this mood which we find in the associates of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a mood of compassion and jiva doya, trying to help all other living beings. And by discussing about Krishna and by chanting the holy names, this quality of compassion, in fact all the 26 qualities will develop automatically just by chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Once Prabhupada explained in Chaitanya Charitamrita that this quality of humility, tolerance, they are not easy, they are difficult. But then Prabhupada says, just by chanting Hare Krishna sincerely, all good qualities will develop automatically. Coming to the childhood pastimes, there is a very beautiful shloka in the Bhagavatam where we'll find later. Parikshit Maharaj asking this question, Nandam kim akarod brahman Yashoda cha mahabhaga. What was the great fortune of Yashoda and Nanda that they were having the supreme Brahman, the source of all the spiritual and material worlds. He is performing his pastimes. What was the austerity they had performed? And Shukadeva Goswami explained that in his past life, Maharaj Nanda was Drona and Yashoda Mata was Dhara, one of the Vasus, you know. And they performed austerities for 12,000 years, taking a simple dried leaves, that's all. You know. Generally, you know, everybody wants some nice prasad. If you go at 9:15, you don't get anything. So we are all, you know, we should get something. Everybody wants, even at least there should be some good prasad. But see the austerities Nanda Baba Yashoda performed for 12,000 years. And then when the Lord appeared, they just wanted to witness the childhood pastimes of the Lord. Now Prabhupada writes the same benefit which Nanda Baba and Yashoda Mata got in participating in the pastimes. That same benefit you can get just by hearing these leelas, by reading the Krishna book, or by hearing somebody reading Krishna book, or by reading the commentaries of the acharyas. You know. It is very hard to understand how is it possible. The same benefit that Nanda Baba and Yashoda and the Prajavasis had when Krishna is doing pastimes, you know, in Vrindavan, Gokula, Leela, you know. The same benefit is attained by hearing. What a transcendentally powerful means it is to just hear. So, like I remember when I was in Mumbai in 1977, so the last year of Srila Prabhupada's pastime, and Prabhupada was giving lecture. It was in Hindi. Sometimes Prabhupada would give in Hindi, sometimes in English. And one devotee was from another country. As soon as Prabhupada began speaking, so he got up because he did not know Hindi. So he was about to leave and Prabhupada asked him, why are you leaving? So he said, Prabhupada, I do not understand this language. So Prabhupada said, it does not matter whether you understand or not. Even if one does not understand the language, if one hears the transcendental sound vibration of Krishna Katha, that is purifying. It is like a medicine. Now, I do not know the details of medicine. When the doctor says, you take this medicine, even if I do not know what is this medicine, crocin, mycin, yorcin, whatever it is, I just take the medicine and get purified and get cured. The Krishna Katha is Bhavoshadi, Nivritta Tarsher Upagiyamana, Bhavoshadi Shrota Manobhira. Who will not take interest in Krishna Katha except one who is a Pashugna, killer of the soul? So, a devotee should arrange his schedule in such a way that he has maximum time of absorption in hearing about Krishna and especially reading Krishna book from Srila Prabhupada's translation. There is a beautiful verse in Damodara Ashtakam where Satyavrata Muni glorifies the, he expresses his desire to glorify the childhood pastimes. He says, Varam devam moksham na moksham vadim va na chane vrineham varishadapiha idam teva purnata gopala balam sada mimanasya virashtam kimanye. Varam devam moksham na moksham vadim va. I do not want moksha, liberation also. I do not want any benediction. But I want that this gopala balam, these beautiful pastimes, may always be enacted in my heart. Even Shankaracharya, who is apparently, he is preaching Mayavad, but at heart he is Lord Shiva, the great Vaishnava. So Shankaracharya also composes these prayers, Bhajagovinda, 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 Mudamate. He is telling his followers, worship Govinda, worship Krishna, take shelter of Krishna by hearing about Krishna and chanting his holy name. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Speaking about this dealings of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I came across one interesting story of how Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu showed mercy to even children. So Shivananda Sen, the very great devotee of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he had performed this service of taking care of all the Vaishnavas as they are travelling from Mayapur to Jagannath Puri. Every year, about 200 devotees would travel from different parts of Bengal. Some would come from Navadvip, some from Shantipur, some from Shrikhanda, and some from Kudinagram. And all the devotees would come together and they would go in procession to meet Lord Chaitanya in Jagannath Puri. In fact, they would attend Rath Yatra, that's around July time. This year, I think, is July 15th is Rath Yatra. And they would stay for 4 months in Jagannath Puri just to relish the association of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, Sivananda Sen was performing this service of taking care of all the necessities of the Vaishnavas. So, one day, you know, he would make sure everybody had the nice accommodation, proper prasadam. And a group of Sivananda Sen and his party, they came to one place, and Sivananda Sen had to stay back. He told the group people, "You go ahead, I have to pay some taxes." Just like nowadays we have vehicle tax. If you want to take a vehicle from here to Delhi by Yamuna Express Highway, you have to pay 200 or 300 rupees, right? So you have to pay tax per vehicle. At that time, there were tax for every individual. So he had to pay the taxes. So he told the devotees, "You please go ahead. I will pay the taxes and join you." The devotees went ahead, and Sivananda Sen was left behind. And they reached the destination, but nobody knew where to stay. And Nityananda Prabhu was very angry. He became very, very angry. He began calling ill names. Gali dene lage. He started speaking ill names. Nityananda Prabhu bhukhe vyakul haila, Sivananda gali pade vasna paila. He became very angry. Where is Sivananda? Sivananda kotha. Where is Sivananda? Kaha gaye? Sivananda kotha gela. And Sivananda Sen was also engaged in service. It was not that he was taking rest or he was eating ice cream or just enjoying. But Lord Nityananda became so angry. He said, "Teen putra mari jai Shivara, ekanan aila. Ami bhukhe mari gaye, mora vasna divaila. Where is that rascal Sivananda? He did not arrange residence for me. I curse him. Let all his three children die because he has not given me residence and I am feeling hungry." Now, we cannot understand this behavior of Lord Nityananda. Is achintya. Lord Nityananda is so tolerant that few years back in Navadvip, some dacoits are attacking him. Jagai Madai. They are throwing pots. And Nityananda Prabhu says, no problem. Chant Hare Krishna. He is smiling. And one devotee, he is a little late in his service, and Lord Nityananda is cursing him, "Let your three sons die." He is called Akarodha Nityananda Paramananda Rai. He is Akarodha, but here he is becoming Sakarodha. He is angry like fire. He is cursing, "Let all the three children die." So this is called Vaishnavira Kriya Mudra. Pure devotee, Supreme Lord, we cannot understand. Actually, why Lord Nityananda behaved like this? Was to glorify Sivananda. He wanted to show how my devotee, even if he's cursed, even if he's misunderstood, even if he's blasphemed or beaten to death, he will not give up service to the Lord. He will not give up his Shraddha. So Lord Nityananda was so angry. In the meanwhile, as he said like this, Sivananda Sen's wife was hearing. She was right there and she started crying. Shuni Sivanandera patni kandite lagila henaka le Sivananda ghati haite aila. So she was crying. How a mother would feel if somebody is cursing that your children die, and who is cursing? Nityananda Prabhu is cursing. Nityananda Prabhu's blessings and cursing, they are very powerful. So she was crying, and then Sivananda came and he heard. His wife said, "Putresha diyache gosai vasana paya," because you did not arrange proper accommodation. He has cursed that our three children will die. And Sivananda replied, "Sivananda kahe bauli keno mari kandiya maruka amaratina putra tara balai laya." He told his wife, "You crazy woman, why are you needlessly crying? Let my three sons die for the inconvenience we have caused to Nityananda Prabhu. Let all our three children die. You know, we are at fault. Now we know Shivananda Sen was not at fault. But a devotee, even if he is not at fault, he accepts blame. He always thinks, I am at fault. And he never gives blame to others. The material world, among politicians, every politician tries to blame other politician. They just see the bad things in others. But a Vaishnava, he sees bad in himself and good in others. Prabhupada gives the example of the bumblebee and the fly. The bumblebee will go to a very dirty place and find one good beautiful flower, a lotus flower, rose flower, and will take all the nectar out of that flower. Whereas a fly will go to a very nice garden where there are beautiful flowers, but instead of focusing on the flower, the fly will find out any dirty place and try to take all the dirt. So we have the choice, either to be like the bumblebee, to see the good in others and thus ourselves become purified, or we can concentrate on the bad qualities of others and ourselves become contaminated. I have seen sometimes when you see fault in others, you're just thinking on the mental level, and gradually you also start developing that kind of mentality. So it is very dangerous to be fault finder. Better to be gunagrahi, see the good in others. So Shivananda Sen, he accepted the curse as a mercy, and then he went to meet Lord Nityananda. And what did Nityananda Prabhu do? Eta boli Prabhu Pashe Gela Shivananda Uthi Tare Lati Maila Prabhu Nityananda. He went to meet Nityananda Prabhu, and Nityananda Prabhu just stood up and just kicked him on the chest in front of everybody. Imagine 200 people are watching you and the leader of the yatra is just kicking you on the chest. What an insult, what was the response? Shivananda said, Anandita Haila Shivai Pada Prahara Paya Shigravasa Ghari Kaile Ghoda Gare Ghiya. He was so pleased. He went and arranged nice accommodation for Lord Nityananda in a milkman's house. And then he caught hold of the lotus feet of Lord Nityananda. Nitai Pada Kamala Koti Chandra Sushitala. Those same lotus feet which are more cooling than millions of moon. So he touched the feet. Charane dhariya Prabhu vasai lai gela vasadiya harshit thaila. He became very happy and he touched the lotus feet and said, Aji more bhritya rupi angikara kaila. Today you have accepted me as your servant. Who will kick another? Only a servant is fortunate to receive the kick of the master. Jemane aparada bhrityera yogya phala dila. You have punished me properly according to my offense. Sashti chale kripa kare ehi tomara karuna. It's a very mysterious point. Sashti chale. Now, sashti means chastising. In the pretext of chastisement, kripa kare. You are actually giving mercy. So very difficult to understand the mercy of the Lord. Sometimes you find devotees also suffering, like in this present crisis of corona or even otherwise. So it's very bewildering why the Lord is letting his devotees suffer. But we can understand that is also an expression of the love of the Lord. You know, whatever the Lord does for his devotee is an expression of pure love. It is a part of the Lord's plan for bringing the devotee back home, back to Godhead. So recently our dear, very senior Vaishnava, his Pankajangri Prabhu, passed away. And so many devotees were offering so many prayers all over the world, Narsingha Puja. And he is a pujari of Narsinghadev. And Janani Vas Prabhu is very dear, his brother, friend, guide, everything. All devotees praying. And then, of course, the Lord's plan on 4th of May, he passed away. And the devotees asked Janani Vas Prabhu, that so many devotees are praying, why the Lord did not reciprocate? Why the Lord did not protect? Janani Vas Prabhu, because he's feeling tears in his eyes, he said, because Krishna is Swarat. He is Swarat, he's supremely independent. He knows what is best for each devotee. And it's our duty to pray, but we cannot be attached to the results. Krishna's plan is supreme. His intelligence is far, far more than what we can comprehend. And a devotee simply accepts. तत्ते अनुकंप सुसमीक्षमानो भुञ्जान एवात्मकृतां विपाकम हृद्वाग वपूर्वीर विदधान नमस्ते जीवेति मुक्ति पदे सदाय भाग. दैट वन हु विद फोल्डेड हैंड्स थैंक्स कृष्णा फॉर ऑल द मिजरीज एंड द डिफिकल्टीज इन लाइफ नोइंग दैट दिस इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ माय ओन कर्म एंड सच अ पर्सन विद फोल्डेड हैंड्स हृद्वाग वपूर्वीर विद हिज हार्ट इज थैंकिंग कृष्णा ही इज फिट टू गो टू द स्पिरिचुअल वर्ल्ड. सो हियर वी सी हाउ शिवानंद सेन इज सेइंग टू द लॉर्ड Today you accepted me as your servant, your properly punishment. Sashti chale kripa kore, ei tomara karuna. This is your karuna, not corona, karuna. This is your mercy. Apparently you are punishing me, but this is your mercy. Tri jagate tomara charitra kona bujhe. But bujhe means to understand. Tri jagate, in the three worlds, tomara charitra, your behavior, kona bujhe. Nobody can understand. ब्रह्मार दुर्लभ तोमार श्रीचरण रेणु द डस्ट ऑफ योर लोटस फीट इज वेरी रेयर फॉर डेमीगॉड्स लाइक लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा हेन चरण स्पर्श पाइल मोर अधम तनु दैट डस्ट विच इज सो रेयर फॉर इवन डेमीगॉड्स दैट हैज टच्ड माय रेचेड बॉडी आज ही मोर सफल हैला जन्म कुल कर्म टुडे माय बर्थ माय माय फैमिली माय religious principles, aaj painu Krishna bhakti, dharma, artha, kama, everything I have got today because I have got your mercy. The mercy of the Lord surpasses all the immediate goals of dharma, artha, kama, moksha and gives one pure devotional service. And then Lord Shivananda Sen, when he behaved like this, Lord Nityananda was very happy. He was just testing. Lord Nityananda was testing. He wanted to glorify Shivananda Sen. Just see my devotee, he is accepting everything as a plan of the Lord. The Pandavas suffered so much, they never complained to the Lord. They accepted, yes, this is part of the plan of the Lord. Nityananda Prabhu Sabha Charita Viparita. Nityananda's behavior is Viparita, opposite. Kruddha hai lati mare kare tara hita. When he kicks someone, it is actually for his benefit. And now we come to the last part of today's story. Shivananda Sen had one nephew whose name was Srikanta Sen. Srikanta Sen did not like this idea that my uncle Shivananda is such a senior Vaishnava, he is the leader of the Vaishnavas, serving the Vaishnavas, and Lord Nityananda, what does he think of himself? He is kicking him on the chest in front of an assembly of devotees. So I don't want to travel with this group anymore. I will go ahead myself. So he left the group all alone. He was a young boy. And he went to Puri all directly. And he went to Puri and he offered his obeisances. Generally when you go in the deity room, you are not supposed to wear stitched clothes. You can put a chadar, but you cannot put on a kurta which has got stitching. If you go to the deity room with stitched clothes, then one might end up getting 7 births as a leper. Very offensive. But Srikanta, because his mind was so disturbed, he did not follow the etiquette. He just offered pranam to the Lord. And Lord Chaitanya's servant Govinda immediately said, Srikanta, aage petangadi utar, take away your kurta or the cloth. But Lord Chaitanya says, Prabhu kahe, Srikanta asiyache mano dukha. Srikanta has come in a disturbed state of mind. Kichu na bolila, kara yate iharasuk. Let him do whatever he wants to do. Do not disturb him because he is already in a disturbed state of mind. Sometimes the devotee may do something wrong and he is himself disturbed. So if we chastise him and speak ill about him, then that will make him further away from the association of devotees. In such a case, it's more important to make the devotee feel comfortable and very loving and kind, and then later on we can correct him. So Lord Chaitanya is showing how to be very concerned about the feelings of the person. According to the rules, Srikanta was wrong. But Lord Chaitanya said, no, let him behave as he is, because he is now in a disturbed state of mind. Lord Chaitanya called for Shivananda Sen's son, whose name was Paramananda. And actually, before the child was delivered, before the child took birth, Lord Chaitanya had told him, when you go back, when your wife delivers a son, you give him the name Puridas. A Puridas means Paramananda Puridas. And actually when he went home, he found out his wife was was carrying the child. The son was born few months later and he was given the name Puridas. So Lord Chaitanya, in this Leela, he called for Puridas. Shivanande jabe se balak milaila, Mahaprabhu padangushta tare mukha dila. Lord Gauranga took out his beautiful lotus feet and he put his toe, the angutha, he put it in the mouth of the son of Shivananda. Why? Because Shivananda Sen was willing to do service even though he was misunderstood and even though he was chastised for no reason. You see, when sometimes we are misunderstood or we may not get credit for what we are doing, still we go on doing service. A devotee knows that Paramatma in the heart, the supreme witness for all my services. You know, there's one camera which is always with us. Not only this CCTV, but there is a camera, Paramatma, PC, Paramatma camera, audio, video, think you, everything is being recorded, you know. What I am thinking, we should be conscious that Paramatma is watching me every moment. So let me always think favorably about other devotees. Let me never think negative. Let me always chant the holy name, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So, I'll end with one story. Lord Chaitanya told another son of Shivananda, chant Krishna, Krishna. But this son was not chanting Krishna, Krishna. And Lord Chaitanya says, I made the animals chant Hare Krishna. Why he is not chanting Krishna's name? And then Shivananda replied, he has received the mantra, but he does not want to disclose before everybody. And later on, this same son, he speaks very beautiful poetry at the age of 7. You know, at those times, the education started much later. But at the age of 7, he composed a nice verse describing Krishna's beautiful features. And that's why he got the name Kavi Karnapur, who is one of the 3 sons of Shivananda Sen. So in conclusion, by accepting the mercy of the Lord in whatever way it comes, one becomes eligible to enter into Braja Leela. This Vrindavan Leela, even childhood Leela or Rast Leela or killing of the demons, it's all transcendent. Janma Karma Chame Divyam. And when we become humble servants of servant and we chant sincerely the holy name, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, then we can enter into this Braja Dham. Just by sincerely hearing the pastimes of Krishna as given by Srila Prabhupada. In fact, this particular 10th canto is the last book which Prabhupada translated. 10th canto, part 1. That book is there in Prabhupada's bed in Vrindavan. You know. So, and Prabhupada ended with Brahma Vimohan Leela, departed. So how much more we should be eager to relish the pastimes of Lord Krishna as given by Srila Prabhupada. Prabhupada actually is translating Bhagavatam sequentially and he stopped in between just to give Krishna book. Because Prabhupada said, I do not know how many years I will be, so let me give the essence. So let us pray to Radha Shyam Sundar Krishna Balaram Gaur Nitai that we can understand these sweet pastimes of Krishna Braja Leela and eventually become purified and enter into those pastimes by pure chanting of the holy name. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Any comments or Vrindavan Vihari Prabhu, Nila Madhava Prabhu? Which comments? Jai Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Sri Vrindavan Dham ki jai, Gaur Nitai Krishna Balaram Radha Shyam Sundar ki jai.